Okay, here we are. The guy is on the in the earthen pond system. No, I'm talking about the cats. It's lovely. That's a Yoruba, language expression made by the entrepreneur. She's talking about the catfish messing up my camera. Oh, Jabba. You remember the last time that the catfish tried to swallow my keys? These ones are not big enough to swallow my car keys yet. But now I'm a little bit more careful. Yeah. This is not bad for guys that are 1 month old. God. And the feeding of cats, it's even therapeutic, man. There's no way one can be angry when you're feeding a fish.
I can be angry.
You can be angry. No, that's a joke. Probably keeping pets and taking care of livestock actually enhances people's
Yeah.
And well-being. Yeah.
Yeah, I think so.
It does. It's not sure.
Compared to jobs like stressful ones like bus conducting and rest, you know, or sitting down in the office all day. So this feeding on the next one. Now here is the agric teacher trying to set them better. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. No, there's a mutual respect among the fishes. They don't bite each other when they are feeding. It's only the bad boys, the shooters, that stays down. They wait for the weakest member of the population to have a tastier protein. But another way to look at it, the protein you are giving them is still about 40%, 45%. But a fish is about 100%. So a big boy will appreciate eating a member rather than wasting time. Getting a 40-something% protein. Even for you, Kwame, you're the king in the environment. You like the best lady now. Okay, what's the question?
No, he's asking for which one is
better. I'm giving this, right?
Between the normal. No, this place, no.
Are you sure?
No, nothing. Wow. No, for my is tired watching catfish eating in a frenzy.
My question is, which one is
okay
better?
Okay, he was asking a question now. Which one is better, right? Between the block and the plastic, where each one has its own merits. Man, he's asking the question, which one is better between the plastic and the concrete? Well, each one has its merits and demerits. I'll tell you 5 advantage of concrete now, the block one, and then 5 disadvantage. Then 5 advantage of the plastic and 5 disadvantage. So you want to start with? Okay, I start from here. Now, advantage, the concrete can be built to any length, right? While they can't do that with the plastic, right? The plastic, the maximum we have in Nigeria for now is 5,000 liters. But you can have 50,000 liters block for concrete. So you are unlimited when it comes to scope and size. Right, then number 2, the concrete pond, the block pond, are you getting me? Is immovable, so it can't be stolen. And poaching and stealing is a major issue in catfish farming, so this is immovable, right? Isn't it? Number 3, this will last long. A well built concrete pond or block pond or raceway will last 50 years in the first instance, unlike plastics that will give you 20 years in the first instance, right? So it's your choice. You can leave this for your children and grandchildren, but this one probably. Maybe you outlive your plastic, of course, that kind of thing. But if it's in a shaded environment like this, well, the experiment is still on. This is a novelty in Nigeria, that kind of thing. So it can last longer, I don't know for now. And then number four, because you are using cement for block ponds, you have this additional free access to neutral water, because most water in cities are acidic. But with the concrete on, with the cement dust, this, a little bit of the cement leaches out into the water and make your water neutral. So that's an advantage for the fish farmer, right? And then number five, well, I'll answer that. I'll probably say that some other time. I can't remember number five. But for the plastic, one advantage is this: you can set up your farm in 24 hours with plastic, sir. Number two, if your landlord is angry that you're succeeding in your fish farm business, you can which always happens in Lagos. You can always escape in 24 hours. I've seen this happen several times where the landlord permits you to have a pond like this at the backyard. After the first success, he increases your rent, you pay. Second harvest, he tells you son is coming from London. What do you do? And he needs access to your two-bedroom flat. You can't park your farm now. So, you're off. Which is...
You can quickly...
Yeah. Untie your pond, dismantle and shift somewhere else. So that's the second advantage. Then the third advantage of the plastic is the fact that it's black. So your fishes here will show more of the catfish color than the one in the block. This one will look more cementish, while this one will be dark. That's number three. Then number four, the plastic has this round nature. Most plastic are round. So it doesn't make a shooter to cage a younger folk anyhow, unlike in the square or the rectangular, where a bad boy can cage you, the gentle fish, in one corner, you know.
He can pin you down
in one corner, right? No, there's no cannibalism will be less in the round plastic than a concrete pond. You can easily, you can easily escape. Yeah, you can be boxed up in one corner. That's the word, thank you. So everyone has his own advantage in that regard. Now, the disadvantage of concrete is this. It's going to take you almost about 20-something to 30 days to build it up. You're going to wait for 7 days for it to dry. Oh, it's a lot of effort, you know, to build up on like this. But with this, you can't take your chance on water quality, because it's as it is. You have to now, how will I say now? You have to make sure your water quality is right, because it cannot actually release alkaline cement dust for you. So you are stuck to the whims of the water quality in the pond here. Yeah. Okay, let me take a short break. I'll continue. Okay, let's look at the second set. Okay, you will know these ones are very hungry now. So the frenzy for the food is there. Okay. Alright, so a spread for the quiet, gentle guys to eat. Now then the bulk of the feeding will now go up at the edge there. The area boys, the shooters, right. Okay. Okay, good. Hey, by the way, we are the Yabatech Secondary School model fish farm for the students, and the fishes are about one month old now, and they seem enthusiastic about the food they are eating. They are past jumbo size, well close to a ballpoint size. And this is feeding time. But Mr. Fish is here to just mention a few things about feeding methodology to actually make us have access to about 1 kg fish on the average in 4 months. Everything seems to be okay for the fish. There's no direct sunlight to make them to be scared of predators like birds. And the oxygen is here from the aerating system to actually increase oxygen from 0.001% to 20%. So with the best food around, which is the food there, without trying to market any feed company, but I think they're using multi-feed for now. Okay, they're using multi-feed for now, but any other food will still do well, high grade, you know. And then good quality food, nitrogen is free in the atmosphere, with the oxygen available, What we have is 1 kg food giving 1 kg flesh. So what we need now is a scale to measure the average size of the fish biomass, so that we can go ahead and start feeding between 10 to 8% the body weight of the fish. But for now, we're going to feed till satiation. Till satiation. And madam seemed to be a little bit apprehensive about the aggressive feeding nature of the fish. But the more glutinous the fish, the better for the customer, because they grow fast, very well, and we can turn over 3 to 4 harvests in a year. That's good news for us. That means the fishes are healthy and everything's going on well. Mr. Fish speaking from the Yabatech project site.